like to welcome somebody who's been an icon not only to people dwelling in Orissa, from Orissa, from a place called Bargarh, but people across this country. You know, this man has so much written about him. This man has so much of documentaries made on his life, on his career, that if I were to start only mentioning where to go and seek information about his life, we would be running into the next 24 hours. One of the videos that was made on his life and the life that he has created for others, it starts with a very, very beautiful a line in Hindi, and that says, "Jin mein akele chalne ke hausle hote hain, unke peeche ek din kafile hote hain." And the same story, you know, that if you were to keep looking at and reading at again and again, you will find this line is, it sums up our guest's life completely. So folks, this evening is dedicated to the struggles, the dreams, the achievements of a young boy who was born as a second child to a very humble and hard-working poor farmer in a small village of Orissa's Bargarh district. Now, this is a place which very few of you might even have heard exists. You might not even know that there is a place called Bargarh, but this is the place where he was born. This is the story of a boy who was a karma yogi right from his early childhood. And this karma yogi, right from his very early days in his childhood, used to take great pride in and dignity of labor in the work that he used to do, right from helping his father in the farms to picking up cow dung from the cow shed or going to the market to sell the vegetables and milk. This evening is dedicated to the story of a man who, despite growing up with very limited avenues of education available to him today, has created a massive opportunity for rural Orissa to avail of world-class education right at their doorstep. He brought world-class healthcare by constructing a massive super specialty hospital for the rural dwellers of Orissa so that they don't have to go all the way to the big city spending money they don't have. He's a man who's giving educational opportunity to more than 12,000 students every year, brings employment to more than 3,000 people each year. And during the course of our conversation with him, you'd realize his contribution and that of his team's contribution during the current coronavirus pandemic that has affected every single person. Folks, this is all that I'm going to be disclosing about him, because this evening, the Saturday Night Spotlight is dedicated to revealing more about him in a biographical and an autobiographical format. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. I call him Murli Ji. He's more popularly known as Krishna Ji, or people call him D. Murli Krishna. But for friends, he's simply Krishna. Thank you so much once again for agreeing to my request. It's been a long time since we last met. I think we met in November or December last year. So since that meeting of ours till today, I've always been wishing to host you on Youth Talks, Murli Ji. And your agreeing to come on board is one of my greatest achievements, I should say, because you've been so busy serving people. You've been so busy being a social entrepreneur like no other. You've been a man who might have created a massive 3,000 million empire, but you own nothing of that. Friends, before I put up any question to him, let's all give him a, you know, we can't give him a standing ovation. We can't give him a round of applause here. Maybe all of our hearts can bow down to his contribution. Murli Ji, namaskar.
Namaskar, sir.
आपसे यू नो प्रश्न पूछने की जनरली किसी की शायद ना वो इमोशनल या स्पिरिचुअल एफर्ट ही ना किया होता है लोगों ने कि आपसे कोई प्रश्न पूछ भी पाए, लेकिन ये शाम हमने आपके जीवन को डेडिकेट करी हुई है, ये शाम हमने आपके अचीवमेंट्स को डेडिकेट करी है. मुरली जी, मैं ये जानना चाहता हूँ कि बर्गढ़ के छोटे से कस्बे में जन्म लेकर आज आप हजारों लाखों लोगों के लिए मसीहा बन चुके हैं. दैट जर्नी हैड मोर स्ट्रगल्स, मोर यू नो सेटबैक्स देन पीपल कैन इवन काउंट. डू यू काउंट योरसेल्फ फॉर्चुनेट टू हैव बीन बोर्न इन अ स्मॉल village like that to a very small poor farmer's family, or do you think it was just sheer chance that you were born? And had you been born to maybe a very rich family, you could have done better wonders. आपको क्या लगता है कि it was something a blessing to you?
Yes, sir. Very good evening, sir. Namaskar. It's a great privilege for me that you have hosted me on your session. And I think I know what to express my gratitude to you for giving this opportunity of interacting with so many audience for being connected throughout the country. And sir, definitely, as the first question that what you asked is, I think I thank God. I'm fortunate enough and I take pride in born in such a family where my parents, both father and mother, gave a lot of values. And I think it's because of them, without the blessings of my elder brothers too, I think, and my sister and my younger brother, I think that's what made me what I am, sir. I think absolutely there's no regret. And I don't think whatever I could able to do, it would have come. It would have been impossible of even visualizing something what I am today. Even I could have been born in some other family. I don't say rich, but any other family, because that's what values carries. When we take into, because my father, though, he was a very marginal farmer. He didn't have any part of a small land. Also, when he migrated for his livelihood to Odisha in early 60s, when sir, Bargad, in this vicinity we have a Hirakud dam. It was one of the most famous dams, agriculture irrigated dams, that both governments did immediately after independence. And early 60s, like many other people, my father migrated from Andhra Pradesh to this part of Odisha in search of the livelihood, and only had something to take care of the family with his own ambition and dreams. He came down, he didn't have anything in hand. But I think the values, what parents has given me, I think it has made me what I am. And absolutely, I feel fortunate and thank God and take pride of being the son of my two great parents, mother and father.
Of course, Muraliji, this question keeps coming up in people's minds, that what would people be if they were born to a different set of parents, if they were born into affluence, how would life be? But you've just put that into the right perspective. Now, you were born to a person who himself did not have the privilege of being educated, but he had the dream of educating his children. How did that dream that he saw, how did that dream saw actualization? वो जो सपना उन्होंने देखा था कि मैं तो पढ़ नहीं पाया लेकिन बच्चों को अच्छा पढ़ने का मौका मिलना चाहिए, अब वो सपना साकार कैसे हुआ? क्योंकि जहां तक मैं जानता हूं, शायद आप बहुत छोटे ही थे तभी कोबरा के काटने से आपके पिताजी का देहांत हो गया था, और आप बहुत अच्छी एजुकेशन शायद पा सकते भी अगर होते तो भी आपको उस समय तो वो मिली नहीं थी. सो हाउ डिड दैट हैपन, एंड इज दैट वन ऑफ द रीजंस बिहाइंड योर क्रिएटिंग सच अ मैसिव एजुकेशनल एम्पायर?
You're true, sir. Actually, as I said, the father, he had a lot of big dreams that he wants his son to get educated. And that to a man seeing dreams where, we were the first generation. We brothers, we siblings were the first generation to get some decent education in our complete family. Maybe my father, grandfather and forefathers. And a man of from that level dreaming and understanding the importance of education. And he wants to give the best of the available education of those days to all the four brothers. And I still remember, sir, because I have my own generation friends of the same village from where we belong to till now. There were two sets of parents that what we visualized today. One who wanted their sons to be part of that particular cultivation profession so that they can be in helping hand to the parents. And because there are some families in my own village who opted their children should be part of their family profession of cultivation. And few like my father who thought of understanding the importance of education. And even my father was always criticized time and again because he didn't have any land of his own. He didn't have any source of income, but still then he had big dreams that he understood the importance of education. He wants his kids to get minimum decent education. And unfortunately, as you said, sir, he struggled a lot in his life to give whatever the basic education that was required for those times. And when we were in a position where my elder brother, the second brother, who was almost in verge of completion of education, was but time to support him. And at that time, I think this snake bite, cobra snake bite, because he was very fond of dairy farm, sir. I think I'll tell you that as well. And he used to give very beautiful cows and buffaloes, and it was even a bread and butter for our family. And he used to grow grass on the fields. Especially he used to, put fertilizer, and he used to, see that grass grows on, so that these cattle feed can be produced and it can be given. And one unfortunate day, he was walking in the field in August 25th, being a rainy season. He could not able to see, and the cobra was just sleeping on the field, and he put his leg on that, and it caught the thumb finger of one of the leg, and it so happened that rapidly the poison flowed down to the brain, and he lost his life there itself within 1 hour of the snake bite. And at that time, it was a very situation where the complete family was in dark, because my father was the only son of my grandfather, and there were no my own uncles were there. And I think my mother and my two elder brothers took care of all the family. And mother gave the support that we have to take it forward. And as I said, because he wanted to get his sons educated, he was in a lot of debts as well. Many of them advised that I think it is a time where you should look forward and should not care for what your father has done by debts. There were people who were not expecting that we those debts, whatever they paid to us in goodwill, they're going to get it back. But we mother and we brother sat down and we told the first point we have to do, that people believed father, and for that we got educated, we have to first of all take care, and we have to repay all the debts. And we brothers, I was I stopped my education when I was into my 12th standard, because I stopped my further education, and we all three brothers got into the same cultivation, and we took a lot of plants on lease, and within 4 or 5 years of hard work, we could able to a stage where all the debts, first of all, the first priority was the commitment of ourselves was to repay the debts, whatever father got it from the market, to see that we educated and to run the family. That was the first step where we feel that the first goal was achieved, and we felt self-esteem was so high that, okay, we could able to at least, father maybe in heaven, wherever he is, I think he'll feel happy that, my son's on the back, I've done the work which was supposed to be done by him. I think that's what we take as a pride. So that particular moment, still, it is a lot of weight. It carries a lot of value and weight in my personal life till now. So that's what honesty is. And we tell that at that small age, that idea coming to we brothers, because my elder brother was just an age of around hardly 20 years. And I was into my 16, 17. My middle brother was around 18, 19. But we felt, let's stand with the honesty. We should have that integrity with us. And that, I think, what helped what we are today. Sir.
Absolutely amazing. Because, it is easy for people to say that we have nothing with us. We can't repay our debts. And having said that, it might have been easy for you and your family, to take your mother to some other city and maybe relocate. Bhaag jana shayad us samay ek aasan raasta tha, lekin aap bhaage nahi. And आपने अभी वही बताया कि इंटेग्रिटी ऑनेस्टी दैट वॉज द बेस्ट चॉइस डिस्पाइट ऑल द ट्रबल्स दैट वर फेसिंग यू नाउ दैट पॉसिबली दोज सीड्स ऑफ अ ग्रेट वैल्यू बेस्ड लिविंग अ लाइफ ऑफ इंटेग्रिटी अ लाइफ ऑफ ग्रेट ऑनेस्टी आई ट्रस्ट दैट वर दोज सीड्स वर सोन वेरी अर्ली इन योर लाइफ बिकॉज इफ आई नो इट करेक्टली बचपन से आपका एक शौक था यू यूज टू बी प्लेइंग विद द काउज इन द काउशेड एंड मेनी टाइम्स एट द एज ऑफ आई थिंक 4 or 5 यू यूज टू बी प्लेइंग एंड देन ऑल ऑफ अ सडन योर मदर यूज टू लुक अराउंड फॉर यू एंड आप दिखते नहीं थे और ढूंढने के बाद पता चलता था तो कहां पहुंचे हैं कि गायों के बीच में उनके साथ जाके सोए हुए हैं एंड काउज वर ट्वाइस योर साइज नाउ लुकिंग एट दैट पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ इंटेग्रिटी आई थिंक वो द्वापर युग में मथुरा में कृष्ण जी की जो कहानी थी और नाम भी आप ही का वही है तो शायद वहां के जो कृष्ण थे गाय के साथ खेला करते थे और ये हमारे कृष्ण ये बचपन में ही आप गाय के साथ खेलना दूध बेचना काउडंग से you know, to create that fuel out of cow dung. Now, was it being told to you to do these things, or it just came to you naturally by observing your mom and dad?
Sir, when I grew up, when my mother used to just share in a lighter way about what I used to do at a very young age of 4 or 5, I used to laugh for myself. But honestly speaking, at that age, you don't understand what you're doing. But even not only my mother, my neighbors, the well-wishers used to always laugh at me when I grew, saying that, no, we used to think that someday a day will come where one of the big cattle is going to, you're going to come under the legs of those cattle and you're going to be, met with a serious accident. I used to play, that's what my mother used to say, sir. But honestly, it's not only that what mother said, but I somehow have a lot of affection towards not only cows, but taking responsibility. Because I, visualize, I feel now that what made me to be among that cows, what made me to get involved in agricultural activities, what made me involved or help providing and helping hand to my father. I still remember when I just passed my matriculation and I went back to my home, I used to work very hard in the cattle farms and agricultural fields. And I used to get a big scolding from father. What are you doing? This is not the job that you have been meant for. I had put you in a school, you study, you concentrate there. But I never felt of sitting idle at home. I used to always support my father, extend a helping hand in form of working in my own cattle and buffaloes that what we have, milking the cows, milking the buffaloes, feeding the cows, because we didn't have any motor. We used to draw the water from the well, and you can understand, so big they require a huge quantity of water, and feeding them water, feeding them food. It was something I used to like a lot, so that particular work. And I used to take it. I think the responsibility was there of helping. I want to help my father. That may be one of the things that affection towards that cows and girls was very high for me. Or maybe working in field was very, passionate for me, because only one thing, my father is alone, let me help. But this is also not the time I was doing. Everybody was doing their share of work. I thought that hard work made me to realize the importance of taking responsibility and engage. That responsibility made me of, taking care of my own whatever. What can do something for it while agencies are not doing for it. This thought process was always in my mind. I think that sense of responsibility right from the cattle area to dairy area to agriculture to some social things used to always bother me. And that's the sense of responsibility, I think, today, whatever, sir, you're saying a few words about me, I think I owe it to my sense of responsibility, because that made me to do all those things what I did at that childhood. I still remember, I used to, grow some brinjals in my agriculture farm. I used to take in my court backyard of our small farmhouse we had. From there, I used to take it, sell it. I used to sit in the weekly market. I didn't have any agitation at the age of 16, 17, sitting in the street of a vegetable market. I used to just sit and come back, and I used to probably give that money and to my mother or elder brother, saying, this is what we got it today. Because I think that sense of responsibility. And I think I still remember the roads is such a bad condition that they approach road and understand the muddy roads to our agriculture farm. That even the bullocks could not able to pull the harvest that we used to have during harvest time. It was such a horrible road that everybody, not only we, the people who used to take that approach road, were suffering. They used to spend a lot of labor. I was just in class 6 or 7, exactly, I don't remember. And one fine day in vacations, I took the initiative. Because at that time, agency, getting somebody from government, it was a distinct dream for anybody.
I think probably you were in class 7.
Yeah, class 7, sir.
Right.
Class 7 it was. And that was such a scenario that we used to unload everything, the harvest, and once again reload it after we crossed the drainage. It was a big drain. It was the somehow the road was so in a mishap condition. I mobilized the people. I called everybody from the village. I made them to sit. I told this is how we can do it. And with the help of the villagers, you know, we ourselves purchased some pipes, put across the road, we across the road, and we laid the mud and we prepared that particular road. And still, when I go to village now, of course, that has been developed by the government agencies. But I stop there and take it as a pride. Yes, this is one work which which made me to understand the importance of sense of responsibility to our society. That's the first works are what I feel I did. Not only like that, sir. I was the first person who installed the dish TV. You can understand that those times there was no channels. We used to umbrella dish छतरी जो आती थी सर छतरी वो मैं सर अपने घर में लगाया सब गांव में सबको कनेक्शन दिया ऐसा कोई कमर्शियल उद्देश्य नहीं था जितना खर्चा उतना सबसे शेयर करके सबसे पैसा लेके सबके घर में आया मुझे भी देखना है गांव वालों को दिखाना है सो दैट वाज नो आई यूज्ड टू डू लॉट ऑफ स्मॉल स्मॉल सोशल वर्क सर एट दैट एज आई थिंक व्हाट इज सेंस ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी कौन आके करेगा हमको ये करना है ये कहीं ना कहीं कहीं पढ़ा नहीं था कहीं सुना नहीं था किसी ने बताया नहीं था बस भगवान की इच्छा था सर कि वो एक सेंस ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी था कि कौन आके हमको करेंगे हमको ही कुछ करना है चलो हम ही कर लेते हैं तो ये सेंस ऑफ बचपन से मेरा अंदर था सर और इतना ज्यादा मुझे पैशन शौक है कि अभी भी गाय रखा हूँ सर इतना मैंने अभी मेरे पास अराउंड 39 ब्यूटीफुल काउस हैं जब रिलैक्स होना है तो वहाँ चले जाके बैठ जाते हैं तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है आई थिंक समहाउ द अटैचमेंट टुवर्ड्स काउस इट्स इमेंस व्हिच आई कांट एक्सप्रेस सर
एब्सोल्युटली आई नो You have always been rooted and connected to the rural India, and you have never forgotten your roots. And this is what I know of you very, very well. Your humility is your signature. And this is something that you rightly said right now, that this started all the way when you were a young child. जो आजकल हम बड़े बड़े मैनेजमेंट कॉलेजेस में पढ़ते हैं पढ़ाते हैं शायद आपके कॉलेज में भी ये पढ़ाते होंगे एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप में देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड क्राउड फंडिंग एंड क्राउड सोर्सिंग यू डिड इट almost 3 to 4 decades back, you crowdsourced and created a, culvert. You crowdsourced and, got your entire community, maybe a dish antenna. So I trust there is so much to learn from you. I'd also like to understand from you that you could not go into too much of higher education, maybe the kind of education that you could have done had you been given the resources. आपने आईटीआई में जाने का मौका आपको मिला शायद यू वेंट टू आईटीआई एंड डिड अ प्राइमरी इंजीनियरिंग कोर्स देयर एंड यू आल्सो आफ्टर पॉसिबली उसमें से बाहर निकलने के बाद यू आल्सो वर्क्ड एज अ हेल्प एट अ राइस मिल फॉर 6 months 6 महीने राइस मिल में काम करने के बाद आपका जर्नी जो आईटीआई का क्वालिफिकेशन का जो आपने लिया था आई थिंक इट स्टार्टेड इन ट्रैक्टर गैराज आपने शायद अपने फार्म में कभी ट्रैक्टर चलाए होंगे तो यू वेंट इन यू नो गॉट योरसेल्फ अ जॉब इन अ ट्रैक्टर गैराज कैन यू टेल अस अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट दैट यू नो पार्ट ऑफ योर लाइफ बिकॉज आई नो एंड आई हैव हर्ड दिस फ्रॉम यू टू दैट वाज वन ऑफ योर पॉसिबली वन ऑफ योर डिफाइनिंग पीरियड्स ऑफ योर लाइफ एज वेल नॉट द जॉब टू एंश्योर दैट योर एम्प्लॉयर बिकम्स बेटर ही गेट्स मोर प्रॉफिट थ्रू योर प्रेजेंस सो कैन यू शेयर अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट दैट
Exactly, sir. Like I said, unfortunately, after losing my father in the year 88, I still remember. 4 years we worked very hard in the field, sir. I forgot everything. I was in my intermediate 12th. I discontinued my studies. No studies till 4 years. And one day, fine day, I still remember the place I was sitting in my agriculture field where the cultivation works were going on. There were some sparks. I thought something I have to do. I think this is not the way I'm going to lead my life. This personal thought came to me as just you can understand the fields, जो रीड बोलते हैं सर एक एक फील्ड और दूसरा फील्ड के बीच में जो रीड रहता है उस पर बैठ के एक थॉट इसीलिए आया था कि गांव में किसी का शादी हो रही थी तो शादी हो रही थी वो सिविल डिप्लोमा सिविल इंजीनियर थे तो एक बहुत बड़ी एक ना सर एक होता है ना सामाजिक एक सोशल एक स्टैंडा जो बताती है एक सिविल इंजीनियर है एक अच्छी घर में शादी एक अच्छा घर में शादी हो रहा है वो सक्सेसफुली पढ़ा है तो ये कहीं ना कहीं एक स्पार्क मेरे अंदर जागा सर कि आई स्टिल रिमेंबर कि दिस वाज स्पार्क आई हैव टू डू समथिंग इट्स नॉट द वे दैट लाइफ इज गोइंग टू गो आई अप्रोच माय एल्डर ब्रदर मैं दोनों भाई पे अप्रोच किया तब तक मेरे नंबर भाई अपने ग्रेजुएशन खत्म हो गया था भैया मुझे फिर पढ़ना की मुझे इच्छा है अनफॉर्चुनेटली सर द थिंग इज दैट नोबडी एक्सेप्ट माय सेकंड ब्रदर वेर एजुकेटेड. हमको मालूम नहीं था कि मैट्रिक के बाद क्या होता है, कि डिप्लोमा होता है, प्लस टू होता है, प्लस टू के बाद ग्रेजुएशन, ग्रेजुएशन के बाद यूनिवर्सिटीज होते हैं. नथिंग वॉज इन अवर माइंड. पढ़ना था तो उस वक्त सर यहाँ एक गेटिंग एजुकेटेड आफ्टर नो यू स्टॉप योर एजुकेशन और आपको फिर पढ़ाई करना, कहीं एडमिशन मिलना इतना आसान नहीं थे. तो कहाँ मिलेगा, तो आई टी आई में मिल जाएगा. तो आई टी आई पढ़ने के लिए मैंने अप्लाई किया. ट्रैक्टर्स का कुछ शौक था, ट्रैक्टर के साथ काम करते थे. मुझे डीजल मैकेनिक एक ट्रेड थी सर आई टी में, तो मुझे डीजल मैकेनिक के लिए मैं अपने वहाँ अप्लीकेशन भरी. तो वहाँ मुझे वेटिंग लिस्ट में रखा गया. 15 दिन गए, 20 दिन गए, महीना भर गया, बोला गया कि डीजल मैकेनिक का सीट्स खाली नहीं है, और अगर आपको यहाँ एडमिशन लेना है तो स्टेनोग्राफी, यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द स्टेनोग्राफी. तो स्टेनोग्राफी एक साल का कोर्स है, आप पढ़ना चाहेंगे तो इसमें पढ़ सकते हैं, नहीं तो सॉरी वी कांट हेल्प यू फॉर डीजल मैकेनिक. तो मैंने फिर उस पढ़ना तो है, एक बार घर से बाहर निकल के कुछ करना है. तो गवर्नमेंट आई टी थी, तो वहाँ स्टेनोग्राफी एक नई नई कोर्स, तब टाइपराइटर्स का जमाना था सर. तो फिर स्टेनोग्राफी चलो एडमिशन लेना है वहाँ लेके, फिर स्टेनोग्राफी एक साल पढ़ने के बाद वहाँ से बाहर आए. तो फिर भैया जो बड़े भैया थे वो मेरा एक नौकरी लगवा दी. बरगढ़ शहर में एक राइस इंडस्ट्री था, उनकी अच्छी खासी बिजनेस थी उस वक्त, और बहुत सारे जगह में थे. तो उनको एक स्टेनोग्राफर, एक पर्सनल सेक्रेटरी की जरूरत थी. तो मेरा स्टेनोग्राफी क्वालिफिकेशन देखते हुए मुझे उन्होंने अपनी एक वो भी एक रिकमेंडेशन मुझे रख दी उनकी जगह. और आई वर्क देयर फॉर सम टाइम. एक साल के बाद फिर वन ऑफ आवर रिलेटिव हु वाज द हु टुक द डीलरशिप ऑफ ट्रैक्टर्स, क्योंकि ये एग्री बेस्ड एरिया है. तो ट्रैक्टर्स डीलरशिप आने के बाद उनको, वो भी ऐसे ही थोड़ा इज नॉट दैट एजुकेटेड, उनको लगा कि मुझे कैसे कोई थोड़ा मोटा पढ़ा हुआ बंदा चाहिए जो मेरा एक डीलरशिप में बैठे. जो यहाँ से कालाहांडी नाम सुने होंगे सर, एक डिस्ट्रिक्ट है जो कि वेरी फेमस फॉर डिफरेंट रीजंस है. तो उस वक्त वहाँ मुझे लेके बैठा है. उनको जब भैया को रिक्वेस्ट किया कि आप उनको दीजिए, हम लेके जाना चाहते हैं. तो फिर आई शिफ्टेड माय लाइन फ्रॉम दिस राइस इंडस्ट्री एज ए पर्सनल सेक्रेटरी टू यू नो एज ए सेल्समैन ऑफ ट्रैक्टर्स, जो कि स्वराज की जो ब्रांड नो ब्रांड ऑफ ट्रैक्टर्स. आई स्टार्टेड देयर एज ए सेल्समैन एंड आई डेवलप्ड अ व्यूज मार्केट because it was a vacant market. Nobody understand what the tractor was, because at those times, the two in the district of Kalahandi, tractors was something very new for these farmers, and they never used to cultivate through tractor. They were depending on bullocks. But with a lot of hard work, we could able to create some market in and around districts. And our work was so appreciated by the company of Swaraj that even they helped us to give our later on the dealerships for Bargarh. Then I started selling of tractors in my own district, Bargarh. And इस दौरान सर ये जो मैंने कहा sense of responsibility जो बचपन से था, tractor तो बेचते गए लेकिन उसका service and sales नहीं हो पा रहा था, जिसके वजह से लोगों के अंदर, क्योंकि tractor हम बेचते हैं, हम सामने में जाते हैं तो लोगों को कहते हैं कि आपका tractor, वो हमको आके सुनाते थे कि आपका मालिक हमारा बात नहीं सुन रहे हैं, हमको spare parts नहीं है, गाड़ी जो है tractor जो है no, it used to break down in the fields for 2 days, 4 days, 7 days for lack of spare parts, availability of spare parts. Then I talked to my brothers and told that I think maybe hard work I did, but I think I'm not doing justice to these farmers. Mujhe unke liye kuch karna hai, because they're not able to get these spare parts. And I'm also thinking of doing something for myself. How many days I'm going to work for some other firm? And this right time has come where I think I should start one spare parts shop. So that is going to be my own business unit, and also I'm going to help these farmers who believed me and purchased these tractors, so that they should not face any harassment. And that made me to start my small venture of business. But the biggest problem was money. Paisa kahan se laenge? So, mere bhai, bade bhaiya jaise hain ki sir, wo thoda enterprising the. Papa jaise abhi bhi bahut active rehte hain. Chalo, karna hai to kar lo. Fir main aapko 50,000 kahin se jugaad karwa deta hu. So 50,000 unhone kahin se dilwaya. Uska baad fir main fir sir. बर्गढ़ में शॉप खोल के 50,000 प्लस दोस्तों से इधर उधर करके टोटल 1.5 लाख इन्वेस्टमेंट से मैं 94 में शायद शॉप को चालू करते हुए, और बिकॉज द ओनली फोकस वाज दैट आई विल कमिट माय सेल्फ फॉर द सर्विस ऑफ द पीपल. मैं जिनको विश्वास करके ट्रैक्टर खरीदे हैं उनको सर्विस प्रोवाइड करना है. तो उनको भले ही मुझे दौड़ के कहीं रातों रात रायपुर के यहाँ से अपने नजदीक है सर रायपुर, और रायपुर जाना मे बी और ट्रैवलिंग डाउन टू चंडीगढ़, बिकॉज देयर द ट्रैक्टर कंपनी वाज बेस्ड एट चंडीगढ़. I used to get these parts, and I used to, passion was, okay, it was there. At the end of the day, we have to earn money. But more importantly was how I'm going to provide service to my customers over a period of time. I think that made that business into a successful venture of one of the successful venture of my business, whatever I did till now, sir.
So, you know, all that we have heard from you right from the time we started, it's almost been half an hour. You've never mentioned even once ki mujhe ye apne liye karna tha. Everything that you have done, you always have a thought that what would happen to the farmers, what happens of my customers. When did this start getting into your mind? Because possibly as young as class 5 or 6, आप लोगों की सेवा करना शुरू कर दिए थे. क्लास 7 में क्राउड सोर्स करके, क्राउड फंड करके आपने कुछ कलवर्ट बनवा दिया था. तो ये क्या बचपन से आपके मन में यही सपना था दैट आई नीड टू हेल्प पीपल, सपोर्ट पीपल, या दिस केम पॉसिबली एट अ लेटर स्टेज, ये टू सपोर्ट पीपल? क्योंकि आपकी कहानी में एक प्रश्न आगे जाके पूछने तो वाला हूं, शायद अभी भी वही प्रश्न आ रहा है कि आपने इतना बड़ा एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूशन बनाया, आपके पास उसमें से कुछ भी नहीं आ रहा है. यू आर गिविंग इट बैक टू पीपल. आपने इतना बड़ा सुपर स्पेशलिटी हॉस्पिटल बनाया, आप होटल बना सकते थे. तो ये जो भी चीज आपने करी राइट फ्रॉम दैट अर्ली पीरियड टिल टुडे, यू ऑलवेज हैड पीपल्स यू नो बेनिफिट इन माइंड. अब वॉज दिस समथिंग दैट वॉज गिफ्टेड टू यू लुकिंग अराउंड इन द फैमिली, जो संस्कार शायद मिले वहां से था, या कहीं पे आपने कुछ गलत होते देखा बचपन में और ये चीज उस समय आपके दिमाग में आई कि इफ आई लिव माय लाइफ आई नीड टू बी इन द सर्विस ऑफ पीपल?
सर, टू बी ऑनेस्ट, एट दैट एज टेलिंग दैट आई वांट टू बी कंप्लीटली सोशल, आई थिंक मे बी रॉन्ग, बट अननोइंगली नाउ आई रियलाइज दैट दैट वाज अ सेंस ऑफ रिस्पांसिबिलिटी. बट एट दैट टाइम देयर वाज इंटेंशन दैट लाइवलीहुड वाज आल्सो वन ऑफ द fact in my mind when I was doing this particular, my shop and other things. But as you said, sir, I'm not that I want to do only service that was only made me to do, but always one thing, why we are going to depend on somebody to get some things done, maybe that culvert or maybe that, you know, doing something from a village in form of what are the word you used, I forgot. That's what contribution you said. I am not, because it may be in the books, crowdfunding. No, that is, you are saying now I'm hearing is a crowd, that something term is there called crowdfunding in business. But that I never knew that there's something of that kind. But my only always looking at was, why we are going to wait for somebody is going to come and do, why can't we ourselves get involved and do that? I think that only made me, sir, to do all those things. Like, my customers who believed me, I can't, at any point of time, I can't cheat those customers. I am liable to them. I am answerable to them. And that sense only made me to, that business grow, and I really did very well, and still now it's going on. My younger brother is looking after it. But that sense of, as I said, that honesty, that part, that commitment kar diya to humko pura karna hai. It's about commitment that we did. And once you committed, you have to do justice to the people who believed you in whatever you're doing. And that sense of value made that. But as you said, sir, education institution, start of education, the same thing, sir. Because western part of Odisha, I think it's a place which is around 400 kilometers from the capital city of our state, Bhubaneswar. And Vishakhapatnam is around 450-80 kilometers. We are located in such a place, and Chhattisgarh, of late, it has become a state. Before that, it was a part of Madhya Pradesh. And we all of us know in history that why Chhattisgarh got separated, because they also felt that Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, the development part was not that accessible to the capital city of Madhya Pradesh, as Chhattisgarh was suffering. And we western part were suffering. In such a scenario, qualitative education was the biggest issue in our part of Odisha here, where you'll not believe even the best of the bureaucrats used to hesitate to come to this part of Odisha to get posted because of the concern of education of their children. And the same thing even we had. And when I was sitting in shop, and we used to always think of, because fortunately, sir, one more thing, as you said, father migrated. Our natives are from Andhra Pradesh. We don't have any link with Andhra Pradesh right now. But somehow you have that values, you carry that culture and values that were from where you belong. Maybe I was not born there. But that thing, the way the corporate institutes enter into education, how they've been flourishing, how they're doing in small places, was also a bit of inspiration for us to start these institutes here. One fine day, one of my very good friend, Bhaskar, the managing director of Vikas Group, he also lost his father at an early age. He was also wanted to do something, but he was confined to this cultivation because he was also the only son. And we both were schoolmates in the school that we studied, and I'm senior to him 2 years. And he used to call me always Dadu. But means in Odia, it is no elder brother. Bro, you can say, sir, not today's language. And he said to me that, why can't we think of something like starting a school? And I said, I'm always, you know, little very aggressive because father values have come. Immediately I told us, we can do that. Why can't we? I think we can think of it because our children are suffering. I still remember, sir, it was the first year of my elder child, Vivek, I put him into kindergarten, the basic kindergarten, LKG, lower kindergarten level. You'll not believe he went to school for the whole of the year and he could not able to learn the first three alphabets. I'm not saying that it was a mistake of the school, it was a mistake of my son. But that incident also, that day when he discussed at the end of the academic session, it was still remembered in the month of March, he approached me that, why can't we do this? Then I told, yes, why can't we? Because that always used to haunt my mind. Everybody is saying no institute. But why can't somebody take this initiative of starting an institute? And we thought of that, I'm going to sit in my own automobile shop, which was doing very good. And the other partner, Bhaskar, he was also busy in his own schedules. We thought of finding one more person who can be, you know, taking care of this institution day and night. And we are going to busy on our own business, existing business of mine, spare parts, and his agriculture. And that way, we brought into Srinivas, who happens to be the youngest director, until a few days before. Now our sons, the second generation, entered into this management. And we brought him and we told them, we are going to take care of the institution and we are going to do our own businesses. And you know, sir, we were enterprising, we thought of starting these schools. But within 3 months of starting these schools, along with my own brother, second brother, who is also working in LIC of India, we four active promoters of this institution till now. We all four came together in a hope that we'll hand over everything to Srinivas. He's going to look day in, day out, 24/7. And we three are going to concentrate in our own existing businesses, whatever we are doing. And we are going to help Srinivas in looking after this institute whenever it is required. This was our initial plan. But within 3 months, it came to know, sir. And because I said, always, I thank God that I got in interaction with one of promoter who told me, this is not the school is going to run. If you want to run, you can't run in rental campuses. And he gave me one, he visualized, there was a dream of mine that we want to do something good, some qualitative institute. But we require some guidance or some mentors in life who can help you to do well. And when his interaction with me on his visit to this part of Odisha helped me, he made me to visualize my dream that how an institute should be. And within same day, I could be able to realize and visualize, no, this is not the way. If you really want to do good, I think you have to think beyond this, because already in 3 months, parents' expectations have gone well and parents are expecting this Vikas itself is going to do well. This, somehow parents' expectations have come up. And then we all, two, and my brother also, over a period of time, we also become very active. But immediately we two, hand over my business, existing business of spare parts to my younger brother. Bhaskar leased out his own lands, and now we both of us, and along with Srinivas, the three of us actively got involved from 3 months after starting. And within the next 2-3 years, Nagesh, sir, my brother, my second brother also involved, and we four. Situation came to that level, that keen observation of doing something good, dedication was required, and we thought we left our own hopes over a period of time. And in village, we used to stay in Baragarh town for some time. But being boarding schools, we felt that our presence is at most importance in the campus. We left our home and we, till almost 13 years, we are now staying in the campus in the same staff quarters where our staff are staying. And it's wonderfully, we are, because we stay as a family, sir. It's now a big family, as you said, 3,000 odd employees are there in all the places. And now starting in 2002 from Baragarh, then doing something, because we all started adding, as you said, we didn't do anything for ourselves. We thought of, let's expand, keep on doing something good, whatever that was required with time, maybe CBSE school, senior secondary state board courses, undergraduate courses. We kept on adding these courses for a period of time. वहां से फिर हम भुवनेश्वर चालू किए, संबलपुर किए, भवानी पटना जो कलहंडी जहां से मैं चालू किया था, मैं अपनी एक प्रोफेशन, मुझे लगा कि वहां एक वीकनेस है कि वहां कलहंडी आज भी सर वहां लोग उसको बैकवर्ड एरिया कहते हैं, तो वहां भी जाके हम स्कूल चालू किए। फिर अभी झारसुगुड़ा राउरकेला और एक दो से अच्छे इंडस्ट्रियल शहर हैं उड़ीसा के, वहां हम लोग अभी इस साल चालू कर रहे हैं। तो ये एक्सपांशन डेडिकेशन के साथ चलता रहा, जहां हम लोग सब वहां एक इन्वॉल्व होके फिर करते गए सर। एंड बट एज ए सेड आई थिंक हमने ऐसे इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर खड़ा किए जहां हमको एक ही लगा कि वी हैव टू क्रिएट वर्ल्ड क्लास, मे बी अ स्मॉल प्लेस बट नो दैट इंस्पिरेशंस आई थिंक एनी डाउन साउथ ऑडियंस आर हियर, दे कैन अंडरस्टैंड। एक था कि ना कि अगर पुट्टपर्ती में अगर साई बाबा जी अगर इतने अच्छे वहां एक हेल्थ केयर एजुकेशन एक छोटी सी जगह मैंने कस्बे में कर सकते हैं स्मॉल इंटीरियर प्लेसेस में, तो एक ना आता है ना सर कहीं ना कहीं से आपको इंस्पिरेशन लेना है, तो हम लोग क्यों ना हम लोग बरगद जैसे जगह में कर सकते हैं। तो वो एक इंस्पायर किया, आज एक वर्ल्ड क्लास इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर हम क्रिएट किए हैं सर। और जहां हम लोग किए हैं यही है कि सोच यही था कि एक ऑलराउंड सोच थी, नॉट ओनली क्रिएटिंग इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फॉर स्टूडेंट्स द स्टाफ, तो आवर्स इज सच एन इंस्टीट्यूशन वेयर आई कैन से विद प्राइड मे बी इन कंट्री कैन कंपेयर देयर विल वेरी वेरी फ्यू इंस्टीट्यूशंस वेयर देर बी बिल्ट। हम जहाँ कैंपस चालू करते हैं वहाँ सबसे पहले रेसिडेंशियल ना एकोमोडेशन क्रिएट करते हैं स्टाफ के लिए, सो दैट स्टाफ आके वहाँ रह पाए। तो हम उसी स्टाफ क्वार्टर्स में हम भी रहते हैं, वहाँ स्टाफ भी रहते हैं। तो वैसे जहाँ जहाँ अपनी बोर्डिंग स्कूल से वहाँ हम स्कूल जैसे बनाते हैं, स्कूल के साथ साथ रेसिडेंशियल क्वार्टर्स भी क्रिएट करते हैं, क्योंकि हम बोर्डिंग स्कूल चलाने के लिए हमको टीचर्स की जरूरत है। और आप जानते हैं कि एरिया स्मॉल एरिया ऑफ वेस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ उड़ीसा, no, because people live in villages, interior places, so that they come, they will get a shelter, they will get accommodation, so that they will help us in taking care of students. And overall, when we take care of students' infrastructure, staff infrastructure, then comes sporting infrastructure. I think we have one of the best sporting infrastructures in all the schools. I think we, once again, we take it as a pride that Vikas is having two cricket grounds of international standards, a BCCI, which is taken these two grounds, या first class matches होते हैं, तो आप imagine कर सकते हैं एक basic CBSE school में एक beautiful 8 pitches slate cricket ground के साथ। इसीलिए कि हमको BCCI देने के लिए बनाए हैं, हम चाहते हैं कि इस rural belt से हम लोग the best of the poor, no, talent को निकाले, and I think this facilities help to create get the poor, talented pool of students, जहां बच्चे आज उड़ीसा team में अंडर 23 आपके रणजी ट्रॉफी, अंडर 23, अंडर 19, अंडर 16 में हर टीम में एक या दो बच्चे विकास के होते हैं, कि उनके लिए उस प्रकार की यहाँ फैसिलिटीज क्रिएट की गई, जिसके वजह से नॉट ओनली क्रिकेट स्टूडेंट्स डू वेल इन एथलेटिक्स, डू इन स्पोर्ट्स, अदर स्पोर्ट्स एंड गेम्स, नाउ स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ विकास आर हैविंग नेशनल रिकॉर्ड्स इन CBSE एथलेटिक्स। आज लॉन्ग जंप प्राउडली वी से 15.7 मीटर्स वन ऑफ आवर ट्रिपल जंपर जंप, एंड उस साल रिकॉर्ड किया 2012 में सर। You can imagine 2012 में जब ये रिकॉर्ड 15.7 उसी साल नेशनल अपना ओलंपिक्स हुए थे लंदन में, उस साल क्वालिफाइंग था 16.2 और मेडल था 16.8। तो हम एक प्लस टू बच्चा बिना कोई किसी हमें 15.7 तक पहुंचाए थे। तो इस प्रकार एक अचीवमेंट्स भी जो है करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज, स्पोर्ट्स, गेम्स, ऑफकोर्स एकेडमिक्स वी आर रियली डूइंग गुड इन दिस पार्ट। आई थिंक समहाउ नाउ दिस विकास इज नॉट ओनली इंस्टीट्यूट सर, इट्स ऑलमोस्ट इसे एक समाज की एक रिक्वायरमेंट को पूर्ति कर रही है दिस पर्टिकुलर इंस्टीट्यूशन दैट व्हाट वी आर डूइंग। एंड विकास इज नॉट नोन एज एन प्राइवेट एंटरप्राइज, इज नॉट नोन एज अ कमर्शियल एंटरप्राइज, रादर आई एम थैंकफुल दैट विद द वे वी टुक इट फॉरवर्ड ओवर लास्ट 18 इयर्स हैड मेड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सोशल एंटरप्राइजिंग, एंड नो इट्स मोर फॉर द सोशल कॉज एंड इट्स अ सोशल इंस्टीट्यूट रादर देन अ प्राइवेट इंस्टीट्यूट, दैट हाउ वी कुड एबल टू नो एन इमेज, ब्रांड इमेज वी कुड एबल टू क्रिएट फॉर द इंस्टीट्यूट।
Wow, that is an amazing, you know, series of initiatives that you took right from 2002 to putting up your in a school, and then how the school happened with four of your partners, your brother coming in, and the sporting facility. I'm very sure very soon BCCI might want to have some of the international matches at your facility, and I'm sure
I'm just stopping you, sir. I'm visualizing why, you know, sir, because now there'll be matches without audience. That's what the BCCI is declaring. the day it reminded that why can't then these big matches should come to small places so that they can play and do that. The world should understand the power of the rural India. No, that thought also came to my mind, sir. Thankfully, let's hope something special is going to happen.
I'm sure that will really happen and happen very soon because you have the world-class infrastructure for sporting already made available. 2002, possibly jab aap shuru kar rahe the school and you just mentioned about your son not being able to get the best quality education. Ek aapke khud ke charitra se juda hua ek prashna tha ki you've been a very remarkable leader. You have created institutions. You have created a series of leaders behind you. One of the leadership qualities has always been humility, and you are humility personified. I remember there was an incident that happened jahan pe aapke samne reporters the, and there was a reporter from an English daily. Aur aapne wahan pe announce kiya tha ki we are going to be putting up an English medium school in a rural region like ours. And that reporter mentioned, aapko kaha tha, ये दूध का डिब्बा वाला अंग्रेजी कैसे सिखाएगा. तो उस समय जब रिमार्क आपको ये मिला था, ये टॉन्ट आपको किया गया था, एक अंग्रेजी रिपोर्टर ने आपको ये टॉन्ट किया था, व्हाट वेंट थ्रू योर माइंड? डिड यू हैव दोज सीरीज ऑफ एंग्री थॉट्स कमिंग इन इनटू योर माइंड और समथिंग एल्स हैपेंड?
So that particular incident, what happened, it was the first press conference that we had when we thought of starting this school in the year 2002. I still remember that. I'm really thankful to that man. He's no more in this world. But that statement never made me any angry, sir. And rather, it made me realize that, okay, you are taken up a challenge. And absolutely, some point of time, what he said, you should be serious. We are not from their background. We don't have that education. Where you are going to hire principals and teachers, and sir, the most people who really want to take this institute forward is these people, the wonderful faculty members who are highly qualified. You don't have that qualification with you. You don't have any experience. Nobody is there to guide you, isn't it? I think what he said, it should be serious. And that particular point made my commitment more stronger and made me more dedicated. And that statement, I think, is only one of the reasons, sir, why today, if I am able to lead my team, not only lead my team, if I am able to technically guide my team, because we're having 18 odd principals with directors and deans in the group of institutions, and with the fast changing curriculum that is coming into this teaching learning process, rapid changes that are happening. I think in this scenario, if I am able to not only leading as a chairman, they think me that I am their guide and mentor right now, because I am very small when compared to education wise with them. But that statement of that wonderful gentleman made me so committed for myself that I became a keen observer, that I have to prove this man at some point of time that I can do this as well. And that made me a very, very keen observer in the complete schooling part, day in, day out, right from teaching, learning methodologies, both academics and administration. And honestly speaking, sir, today, that if I sit for any review meetings, I have some principals meetings, and not that I do something, but they have a lot of, my team has a lot of expectations that we go to him, maybe he's a principal, maybe he's a director, maybe he's some in a higher position, that they think that this man can guide us, maybe in technical part of academics also. And I am, if you ask me some question on mathematics, I can't answer, to be honest. But when it is coming to how we have to take this program forward, I think, I also have that confidence in me that I can guide anybody who comes in front of me. And even my people have that immense faith on me. And this all happened because that man gave the statement and took, it's always walked as the accelerator for me. Always made me remind that, see, you're not from the background and you have to take care for yourself. That made me more involved and more committed, and I'm thankful to that person wherever he is.
Like all great people do, they use some of these incidents as a factor for motivating them, and then they question themselves ki ye sahi to nahi bol raha hai, shayad isko hum apna advantage kaise banaye. And possibly that is one of the biggest qualities of a leader. Getting back to the leader in you, now, you've been a social entrepreneur and a social reformer That part of your leadership has always been established for almost 3 decades now. You also have been an industry leader. You've been a leader in many other spaces. There is one thing which, always comes to my mind. ये हम सोचते हैं बहुत बार के जो बहुत अच्छे व्यक्ति होते हैं, जो बहुत पढ़े लिखे लोग होते हैं, सुनने में बहुत आता है, ये जो अच्छे लोग होते हैं ये राजनीति में नेता बनने की कोशिश नहीं करते हैं. लेकिन एक और भी, there is another school of thought which says if in politics, if राजनीति में अगर अच्छे व्यक्ति नहीं आएंगे तो राजनीति अच्छी कैसे होगी. आपके बारे में भी बहुत अच्छे से ये लिखा जाता है और कहा जाता है दैट मुरली कृष्ण जी हैज बीन अ वंडरफुल लीडर इन रियल लाइफ. ही इज ऑल्सो प्रूविंग टू बी अ ग्रेट पॉलिटिकल लीडर एंड अ मेंटर. कैन यू शेयर अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट योर पॉलिटिकल लीडरशिप, द जर्नी दैट पुट यू इनटू द थ्रोंग्स ऑफ एंटरिंग पॉलिटिक्स एंड मे बी ऑल्सो बीइंग रेडी टू फाइट इलेक्शंस.
Sir, right, sir. It's a very small journey of 5-6 years, I can say, 2014 to till now. But as I said, sir, always when I was in my village, I used to think for my village that how I can, how things can be better in a village. It's not that what I'm going to do, how things can be better in a village. When I entered into education, I felt that how things can be better in education for my area. It's not only for my institute, how it will be better for my area. I did something in health sector. How things can be better for my health sector. And all these things, what we did, as you said, sir, it was completely a self-sustained institution, Vikas Assembly. We didn't even take a single patch of land from government agencies, nor donations. Only it is completely sheer self-sustained institution from whatever we used to save revenues from the parents' fees collection. We have built up this with the help of the banking financial institutions. I said, without this, if you can do these many things, because that affection and weakness towards doing something for my area made me, if I entered to this political platform, maybe I can contribute something for my complete area, because I'm confined only to institutes now. I can do something with whatever vision that we have that we can do. That, that inclusion has made me to pull towards, attracted towards my politics. But once again, the inspiration was, as you said, sir, it's always said that there's no space for good people in politics. But as I said, I always don't go with that crowd. I say, why not? And this question always made me, why not? That why not made me what I am today. That why not only made me an inspiration was Abdul Kalam ji and Vajpayee ji and our own state, sir. We have Biju Patnaik ji. They're tall leaders. They really, they're great inspiration. And Abdul Kalam ji, from our own generation, we saw him and we grew. And he said that he always used to invite, sir, when he used to go, that come to politics. This is what we used to listen in a lot of his speeches and addresses, and he used to speak to students also. This made that, okay, people say there's no space. That I think, sir, unless and until if you keep on saying that politics is not for good people, then how politics will be good? That made me, but of course, when you come into politics, there'll be some ups and downs, struggles will be there. But life has always taught us to live in struggles. And I'm thankful, sir, today at least people recognize, I was thought of contesting the elections. But as I said, politics is not that a small, easy game. But at least, though I didn't contest elections, but party recognizes me. They understand that we have a good person at Bargat. I think that's more than fighting an election, sir.
So I'm sure in the coming days, we would see you in electoral politics as well, and you would be leading India and that particular region of yours to great glory. We have just about enough time, Murali ji, to take a few more questions, which have been put up by some of our members in the audience. I'm taking one question, which was, very interesting. This has been asked by Dr. Sushil. Dr. Sushil wanted to know that what are some of the mistakes you wished you could have avoided throughout your entire journey? ऐसा कुछ गलतियां जो आपसे हुई जो आपको लगता है कि शायद न करते तो अच्छा होता, एनीथिंग लाइक दैट?
सर, टू बी ऑनेस्ट, ऐसे कोई चीज नहीं है जो कि मैं सोचूंगा कि गलती शायद नहीं करना था. गलती बहुत हुए हैं, लेकिन शायद मैं उतना अग्रसर नहीं होता तो शायद ये भी नहीं कर पाते जो आज हुआ है. तो जब तक आप करेंगे, दस में से 8 काम ठीक होंगे, 2 खराब होंगे. पर मुझे लगता कोई भी काम ऐसे कोई गलती या सही नहीं होता जब आप डिसीजन लेते हैं, जरूरी नहीं हम भी ह्यूमन बीइंग हैं, वी आर ह्यूमन बीइंग्स आफ्टर ऑल. बट आई डोंट हैव एनी रिग्रेट अबाउट व्हाट द डिसीजंस आई टुक इन माय लाइफ. बट एज वन थिंग इज दैट नो आई एम एज यू सेड हम्बलनेस सॉफ्टनेस इज कम्स फ्रॉम वैल्यूज फ्रॉम पेरेंट्स. हाँ कभी कभी बहुत दिक्कत होता था जब मैं सेलिंग नो नो इन मैनेजमेंट में नो बोलना सीखना जरूरी है. नो नहीं सीख पाया कहीं दिक्कत हुई थी. बट धीरे धीरे सर उसको मैं तो रिग्रेट नहीं मानूंगा. बट शायद मैं नो का नो नहीं कह पा रहा था, नुकसान हुआ. लेकिन वो नुकसान ने मुझे नो कहना सिखा दिया है. तो आज लोगों को लगता है कि सॉफ्ट है, लेकिन जहां तक मैनेजमेंट के सवाल आती है तो मैं बहुत टफ रहता हूँ सर, क्योंकि वो मुझे सिखाया है.
सो पॉसिबली आई नो असर्टिवनेस इज यू नो वन ऑफ योर वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग ट्रेट्स एंड आई हैव सीन दैट टू. यू हैव ऑलवेज बीन वेरी हम्बल बट यू हैव बीन हम्बल विद बीइंग असर्टिव. सो यू वुड be able to give the best of your time to people around you. If you can't say, you know, no, it means everyone and just about anyone would take away your time, which can be focused on some important areas of your work. That brings me to another question. This is regarding your hospital that you have, you know, the entire healthcare facility that you bring to people. Aapka abhi ka jo initiative hai, COVID-19, you've created a massive institution. The entire government of India, government of Odisha, project backed by IOCL is managed only by you. These three entities together could have afforded anyone. Some of the best brands could have come to that place and could have, you know, put up a 200-bedded COVID-19 facility. What made them select you? Why you? Why nobody else?
Sir, it's wonderful, sir. Actually, because as I said, health also started with the same thought. Why not? 2002 में एजुकेशन था, 2016 में लगा कि एजुकेशन में जो कमियां थी आज हेल्थ में है. लोग कह रहे हैं कि हम लोग सर यू नॉट बिलीव, इवन आई हैव माय ओन फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम जेसीस एंड माय ओन अदर कम्युनिटी फ्रेंड्स. जो सर समय ऐसे था 2016 से पहले जहां लोग नए जनरेशन के लोग ब्रेन डेड होके बाहर जाके काम कर रहे हैं. पिताजी लोग उन्हें वेस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ उड़ीसा में थे, उनको लेके भुवनेश्वर एक ही शहर था सर उड़ीसा में जहाँ रियल इस्टेट बूम थी, जहाँ मुंबई की जैसे रेट्स आज भी हैं भुवनेश्वर में, मुंबई के बाद कोई रेट्स है. इसलिए क्योंकि लोग खाली एक ही शहर दिखता था लोगों को उड़ीसा में कि भुवनेश्वर में जाकर हमको बैठना है. पीपल यूज टू गो देयर, दे यूज टू सेटल बिकॉज दे डोंट वांट टू टेक रिस्क विद द पेरेंट्स बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव एनी डिसेंट हेल्थ केयर एट सर्टेन एज. तो मुझे लगा कि हमको कुछ करना है, एजुकेशन में क्या हेल्थ में करेंगे. तो मुझे जब हम हेल्थ में गए, हेल्थ को वहां 2016 में स्टार्ट किए, इतना सिचुएशन था कि वी कुड नॉट इवन नो बिकॉज यू सो इट्स अ वेरी वास्ट थिंग दैट वी डिड. बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली मैंने कहा वी आर लिटिल वीक इन ब्रांडिंग. मैं 400 किलोमीटर दूर में रहता हूँ, गवर्नमेंट को मालूम नहीं था हम लोग क्या कर रहे हैं. तो कहीं ना कहीं गवर्नमेंट की पॉलिसीज ऐसे थे उड़ीसा में कि हमको हॉस्पिटल बनने के बाद साल भर हमको परमिशन नहीं मिले. बहुत सारे कारण है सर उसको जो कि शायद मैं बता नहीं सकता. yes. कुछ फीडबैक्स कुछ गलत थे उनके पास. तो अल्टीमेटली हमको परमिशन मिले, हम चलाने लगे. तो हम रिकॉग्नाइज सर एज ए सेट विकास इज नॉट जस्ट प्राइवेट इंस्टीट्यूट, इज अ सोशल वेंचर. वी आर केबल टेकिंग द सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ कैटरिंग गिविंग बेसिक नीड्स ऑफ हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ उड़ीसा. दैट वॉज रिकॉग्नाइज बाई गवर्नमेंट एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कोविड टाइम. बिकॉज यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड सर, आई थिंक वी प्राउडली टेक दैट इन दिस पर्सन ऑफ उड़ीसा नाउ वी आर कंडक्टिंग नो द बेस्ट ऑफ सुपर स्पेशलिटी फेसिलिटीज. वी आर गिविंग ओपन हार्ट बाईपास सर्जरीज. We have best of super specialty departments in almost all the departments that we have. And now people in health sector in Bhuvaneshwar and even in the bigger cities are looking that how can an institute of that kind come into that interior part and it can sustain. People are still having an eye on us. And but we are determined that, you know, it's just 2 years. We are still in, you know, initial phases of our hospital. And as I said, biggest corporates in the country are looking at burgers. Sir, honestly speaking, at the hospital, this is a feedback I'm getting that how could they sustain? How they're going to get the best of the doctors? How can they sustain in that interior part? Because health is really challenging, sir. People who are in health can understand what I'm saying. But we are determined for it, and I'm sure we are going to make. Even bankers asked me that 5 years down, you can't make it self-sustain. How are you going to manage? I took them time of 1 year. But we were supposed to come in 2 years. Unfortunately, Corona has come up. But Corona, maybe it's a big challenge. But I think so the bigger the challenge, bigger the problem, bigger the opportunity. And I think in this time, when we, you know, government approached us that we want that you manage the hospital, COVID hospital at Western Park. They actually told me for two districts. I told that in this scenario, I think I guided for two districts, but we took the responsibility to serve in the lockdown. You can understand the mindset and the country's lockdown scenario, the first lockdown.
Right.
That March 25th to April 15th, no, you'll not believe, no, right around the corner of, no, within 15 days, we could be able to come up with 200-bedded exclusive COVID hospital in this part.
Can if you don't mind, I'd like to show the video of the hospital.
Yeah, please, sir.
Yeah, I'll just, because it's an amazing a piece of effort from you and your entire team. So I'll just let people have a view to this hospital. Magnificent effort by you and your team, Muraliji. This is something which is absolutely astounding, a stunning testimony to your will, to the dint of sheer hard work that you've brought in and then, made something like this happen. Hum log sunte hain ki alag alag deshon mein China created a hospital in just a couple of nights and you have created a massive greenfield COVID-19 super specialty center. I believe this is a great service to people of that region, people of Odisha. Before we wind down and before we say goodbye to people, friends, what you saw today between 7 and 8 right now was a very, very, very small tip of the iceberg from the life of Dasari Murali Krishnaji. There is so much about him that one can know. All that you need to do is just enter that name and search it on Google. You will be filled with millions of inputs about his achievements. So many awards he has won. Such an outstanding human being he is and such a great inspiration, this gentleman is. Before we call it a day right now, Muraliji, your final word to everyone. We are facing challenges. These are tough times. Jobs have been lost. Businesses are seeing massive reversals. Economy, as we see the figures,
the last 11 years, probably this is the toughest year the government is facing. What would be your message to people everywhere who are listening and watching you?
Thank you so much, sir. I think, as you said, the last message regarding the situation of COVID throughout the globe. As I said, I'm always very positive and optimistic at looking at things. But if you ask me, I'm dealing with such a thing which is a basic need, education and health. But when coming to education, now it is the most non-essential part when it is coming to, you know, opening up schools. I think we are the last one to come. But still then I'm very optimistic, sir, that, you know, this is the time that we are going to, you know, we have to pass on. And I think people are understanding it. And over a period of time, and things are going to be settled down. It's a matter of, I think a lot of good things have come up. I think people expect direct benefits, but indirectly, when you look at the government support the government is providing in providing relief, some relief for this temporary phase of period for this financial year, I think we can re-strategize ourselves. Let's be optimistic and let's keep on looking and hunting for the new opportunities that's going to come our way, because we can't just fold our hands and say that let's leave it for the time. Whatever things can come and whatever, you know, we can keep on hunting for the new innovative things that we can do in this situation can help us at least to sustain this period of crisis that this world is facing. But as I said, things are going to be bright. It's a matter of time. This world has seen more bleaker days than this. I think it's an experience where we are going to carry it forward to the days to come. And as said, sir, the last message to everybody, as I said, one thing, as you said, sir, I could not able to complete my education because of a lot of commitments and my family, you know, burdens, what we brothers faced. But I think it was a learning, it was an, you know, blessing in disguise for me. Because if I would have been very well qualified like others, then maybe a thought would have been come to me saying that you know everything. But aap sab jante ho. Because I didn't educate, I think it was a blessing in disguise for me. I kept on looking for learning. Seekhne ki jariya jo hai, jahan se mile, wo seekhna hai. I think I said, sir, we all from, no, I take as a pride that I also from JC's family. Informal learning, formal learning, confined ho jati hai education ke baad. Informal learning, seekhte rahenge, jante rahenge. I think it can give us a tremendous effort to, you know, take our own ventures. Log एक जगह में आके छोड़ देते हैं, सोचते हैं कि ये नहीं हो पा रहा है मेरे के साथ, बट वो दैट 1% एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट ऑफ योर्स टू डूइंग थिंग्स इन अ डिफरेंट वे कैन हेल्प अस टू ओवरकम ऑल द सिचुएशंस दैट वी आर हैविंग. लेट्स कीप ऑन होल्डिंग टू आवर वैल्यूज एट द सेम टाइम लेट्स कीप ऑन लर्निंग एंड नो व्हेन वी लुक एट द अपॉर्चुनिटीज. बिकॉज व्हाट आई डिडंट थिंक दैट डिड समथिंग बिग. आई ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट ए नो प्रॉब्लम ऑफ द सोसाइटी. And I tried to solve that problem of the society. And that made what Vikas is. And I never cared because primary was never for me to money. Primary, paisa kamana hai. Earn money was not my primary goal. I always kept my, you know, stakeholders. Maybe it is students. Aaj agar Vikas mein bachcha ko kuch bhi agar dikkat hua, to log, maine jaise teacher darte hai na kuch gaali dene se, ya fir kuch, maan lijiye kuch aise action ho gaya hai. तो टीचर लोग कौन पेरेंट्स आगे कुछ बोल उससे ज्यादा डरते हैं कि चेयरमैन के पास खबर नहीं जाना चाहिए क्योंकि सर को पता चलेगा तो शायद ही इज गोइंग टू टेक इट अदरवाइज. बिकॉज़ आई डोंट एक्सपेक्ट समबडी टू ट्रीट एट एनी डिफरेंट स्टेक होल्डर मे बी स्टूडेंट स्टाफ एनीबडी. आई ऑलवेज पुट देम अहेड ऑफ माय ओन इंटरेस्ट. एंड व्हेन यू टेक केयर ऑफ योर स्टेक होल्डर्स आई थिंक रेस्ट इज गोइंग टू टेक केयर. यू आर गोइंग टू टेक केयर बाय यू नो द टाइम इज गोइंग टू टेक केयर ऑफ यू. दैट्स व्हाट द मैसेज. Let's not always be, you know, centric, you know, revolve around yourself. Let's put ourselves on the back foot. Let us put all our stakeholders on the front. And when you put on the front, I think time is going to take care of you. That's what happened with me. That message I can give it to you.
What a beautiful message. Put your stakeholders in front of you and everything will take care of itself. Friends, this is a man who's always beaten the odds each time, every time the odds came his way. This is the man who swears by his values, and this is the man who you can always emulate his example of, you know, finding solutions for people's problems and rising through those solutions. And of course, if you want to be iconic, Dasari Murali Krishna is the person to follow. Legend banna hai to inke paas jaiye. कृष्णा इनके नाम ही में लिखा है, मुरली ये जो इनकी एक्शंस है, दैट इज व्हाट हिज लाइफ इज ऑल अबाउट. थैंक यू सो मच मुरली जी फॉर स्पेंडिंग एन आवर एंड प्लस विद अस दिस इवनिंग, नॉट जस्ट शेयरिंग द मैसेज ऑफ योर लाइफ बट गिविंग पीपल a reason to continue doing whatever they are with the right set of values. I believe this is going to help all of us stay on course for a great...
It's a great privilege, sir. I think at the end, I should thank you, my gratitude to you for putting me on this national platform, because Odisha is a small interior place. There are wonderful things are being done by many people in this part of Odisha. I think it just not only so casted me on the screen at national level. I think it's something an inspiration and it's a boost, moral booster for all the people in part of Odisha working, doing a lot of wonderful things. Thank you so much, sir. And my deepest gratitude to you for putting me on this national platform. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much.